Good day, guys. Austin here. And in this one today, we are taking a close look at Halo 3. Now, I am going to be covering the other Halos, but I thought we'd start off with the logical first one on the Xbox 360, and that is obviously Halo 3. Now, we are utilizing the XENIA Emulator. I'm not sure where I pronounce this, but I'm guessing XENIA. It's from the Xbox, so maybe that's how you pronounce it. Anyway, comments down below tell me which way I should be pronouncing this. But anyway, those guys have been working God's work. The gods of emulation have blessed them with what seems to be a now pretty well optimized emulator. We've covered this some time back. In fact, it was probably a few years back now when it started breaking through with the Vulkan rendering, and it seemed to go for a lull for a while. Let's face it, emulation just does that sometimes. But now the ground is running and people are hitting it, and it seems that a guy, I believe it's the name of Ben Venick, he has basically brought in the DirectX 12 rendering, and this has fixed a hell of a lot of games. So I got told that basically Halo is now running all right, or at least some kind of standard. So as it's one of my favorite games of all time, I think it's only my civic duty to boot this up and see how it's working. So without further ado, let's get stuck in. Now, this is Halo. It's exactly as you are hearing it now, and sound-wise, it's looking good. Visually, we have obviously got some glitches going on. There doesn't seem to be, well, lighting and textures just don't seem to be there, but we'll get into game. We'll see how this goes. Currently, I'm running this, as we talked about, on the DirectX 12 modification, or build of this emulator, I suppose you'd say. So, anyway, enough of that. Let's get into it. We'll go normal. We'll go straight into single player game because, yeah, it may be easier run on the multiplayer because, well, let's face it, there isn't many enemies, if any, as standard. And we can't exactly go online with it. So, well, everyone wants to play the single player version. And so far, so good.
They let me pick.
Voice, perfect. Cortana, you are sounding sweet.
Choose whichever Spartan I wanted.
I did hear some speed up on the music, though, or sound effects.
As you became the soldier we
anyway, I'm going to let this run through, but I can't let the sound be proper sound because, well, basically Microsoft or Bungie or whoever it is that owns this now will claim this video and more than likely give me a strike. So I am having to talk through this cutscene, but I do want it to play. Because, well, this is what I want to see in action. Now, with the emulator itself, I haven't got any options to change any of the resolutions or anything like that. So everything is left completely at stock. Because they said, well, this emulator's been around for some time, but let's face it, it's been stagnant for some time also. Ben Vanek bringing in this DirectX 12 has really blown the doors off. We're seeing games like this. Jesus wept, look at that. So we're running at 30 frames per second. This is a 30 frame per second game. In terms of my system, I am being taxed. Look at my GPU, it's at 99%. That's a 1080 running 99% on standard resolution. So
stay sharp.
That's looking good, isn't it? So optimizations. Yeah, we're going to have to look into that, to be honest, because it shouldn't be running 99% on this GPU at this resolution. It's good that it's actually being utilized, so it's not taking all the load from a CPU, but still a lot, a hell of a lot. RAM usage as well, 9 gigs. It's looking sweet on the character rendering, though. I'm liking that. Obviously, the textures aren't proper. It doesn't seem to be so much the textures, more the lighting and the way that's affecting the textures. Does that make sense?
Yeah, you're not.
Master Chief. He doesn't stay down for long, does he?
Why do you always jump? One of these days, you're going to land on something as stubborn as you are.
Oh,
Halo. I don't do bits and pieces.
For me, this is one of the best Halos going. I was a massive fan of 1, huge fan of 1. 2 was, yeah, it's okay. This one, oh, it's been so long since I've played it, but this one was like the end of the trilogy for me. After this, it kind of went downhill. I couldn't comment completely because, to be honest, I haven't completed them. ODST, yeah, it was all right, but it was more like an add-on than anything. All right. Oh, my controller's working. Sweet.
Now down here. Good.
Okay. And we're inverted as well. It's even better. This game just knows how I'm working.
Make it quick. No, it doesn't. We gotta move.
One more time, sir. Up here? Mm-hmm.
Yep. Oh, yeah. Again, down here? It knows how I like to play by doing this. Basics. It's things like this that Halo just gets right.
Everything checks out, Sergeant Major.
Kick off the
of course
training,
it does. Never course. Question me. Especially not in front of the Sergeant Major. So far, this is sweet. Whoa. What's going on with the Arbiter? He doesn't look right.
The Arbiter's with us. Come on now. We've got enough to worry about without you two trying
to kill
each other.
If this is playable. If this is playable right now.
Were it so
I don't mean to say this to put you guys off, but there's going to be a bit of a bulge going on in this room.
Roots up, I said.
And they must love the smell of green.
I mean, I've got a 360, but this now? Playing PC? With the possibilities of enhanced rendering, or at least resolution in the future? That's awesome news. So far, so good. I've got to take my hats off to the XENIA team for doing this, or XENIA, wherever you pronounce this emulator as. Hats off. This is sweet. Please be able to control this right now. Please. By the gods of emulation, bless me. Oh my god. Yes. And look at that. I had a bit of a blip there with the rendering, but I suppose it's acceptable. 28, 29, 30, 32. We're running solid 30 frames per second. This is pretty damn good. And to be honest, a lot of the graphics and the lighting has been cleaned up. I'm seeing slight jitters in the environment. Shader cache doesn't seem to be affected hardly either. This is so far so good.
Up and over, Chief.
I don't know if my voice is putting this across enough, but I'm pretty damn excited
Bravo
right
team,
now.
This is Johnson. We got him. Fall back to the extraction point. Over.
Sergeant Major's all over this, like a rationy. He's like a rat in a shithole, playing around in this jungle. He knows the script.
That sounded close.
Oh, see, this is how Halo is for me. This is the kind of level design and stuff like that that I love. When on Halo 1, when you hit the Halo, and it's just an open world environment, and it's like you're playing it for the first time. It's like, where do you go? Big open world. And at that time, it was groundbreaking with the mechanics of the grunts and the little dudes. It was awesome.
Sergeant Major, Phantom inbound.
I've never seen enemy combat like that in, well, with very bespoke games, let's put it that way. Not in a sandbox environment, which that one kind of was. Or at least it felt like it at the time. Anyway, enough of that. Look at this! Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Whoa, I'm seeing some jitters. That could be the shader cache. No, it doesn't like me swinging over there for some reason. What's there? What don't you like? Come on, XENIA. Tell me your woes. No, it must have been the shader cache. So, in terms of GPU, I'm still pretty high. 92, 90. Is it the water effects, maybe? No? It seems to be the foliage. It doesn't like the foliage. Like, I'm hitting 99. And I'm getting a few little glitches.
The brutes do have our scent. Those boys are
in a lot. Yeah, optimizations do need to be worked on. But again, you know, it's very early days for the DirectX 12 rendering, so we can't really complain too much. Whoa, what's going on here? He's turned into the Predator. I didn't know he was in town. Come on, Jean-Claude. He doesn't like if he was pink, it would be the Jean-Claude version, wouldn't it? Anyway, let's progress. See what's going on. Ah, enemies, first time. How's this gonna go down? Whoa. So we haven't got Whoa, what else is going on? We haven't got bullet rendering. Or at least, you can't see people firing. Ah, we seem to have gone in now, though. And it did freeze, and again, don't know if that's shader cache or what. But I was seeing quite a lot of freezing going on. Maybe it was just too much for the graphics card. Again, this is a 1080 running standard resolution. I think this ran, well, I got no idea. I would guess 720, but Xbox 360 with a game like this, you never know. It could have been even lower. We'd have to go into Digital Foundry to to do some research, wouldn't it? Put it in the comments down below if you know what actual native resolution this game ran at. I'm sure it'd be 720. And there's some overbloom on the light in there. Alright, Chief. Jesus. Okay, so yeah, we have got issues with the rendering of the, well, basically bullet decals, I suppose you'd say. Can I change weapon? Yeah, there we go. You used to be able to double wield on this? So I am seeing stutters from time to time. Is that from the GPU overload? I am seeing solid, except for those stutters, I am seeing solid 30 frames per second though. That's great performance. Again, I wasn't expecting that. And other than those stutters, it's smooth as butter. There is the slightest of glitches every now and again, but it's nothing to write home about. It's playable. Well, that's debatable, I suppose. Depends how often those big freezes come along. Hopefully. No. If it's like this every 2 minutes, then it's not playable, let's face it. I thought we could battle through, but it does seem... Let's see if the GPU... Yeah, the GPU is showing 100%. So I think that is what's bringing this down. My 1080 is the biggest one I've got. I mean, I am thinking about upgrading to the 2080 Ti, but let's face it, those are like a grand and a bit. But could it be worth it for Halo 3? Could be, could be. If you get Halo 3 running at 4K, that could be worth a 2080 Ti. A grand and a bit to play one game. Now, come on. You never know, you could, with the modifications, we should also bring in the RTX as well. Oh, come on. So, yeah, it looks like we have got big issues with the overloading of the GPU. It doesn't seem to be shader cache, because it's not when new enemies come along. It seems to be when there's a lot of stuff going on. Oh, sorry, Arbiter. I thought you were one of the bad dudes then. So, yeah. It does seem to be... is when the GPU maxes out. And yeah, my rig isn't the best out there, but it is pretty much a high-end rig right now. And you know, the everyday Joe who just wants to play Halo 3 shouldn't be expected to have like you know, $2,000 worth of PC to be able to play one game. But I suppose it's the age we live in. Let's see if we can progress through this bit, and then I think we'll call it a day on this one. It does look beautiful, though, as well. It's so close. So close. Sleepers. Take them up. Nice. Look at him. He's gone predator mode again. Let's get over there. Zoop. Alright, what's my melee? There we go. The buttons got screwed up on this from the dual wielding. Take him out. Can I grab this weapon? Yeah. Oh, can dual wield? In your face! Right, let's jump down, get straight into the action. No mess tins. Oh, that didn't go as planned. Let's see if I can sneak up on these before they actually get me. So sound-wise, music-wise, it seems to have fixed itself graphically. Pretty on nigh on perfect, other than in some of the cutscenes you've got lighting issues. There is a bit of overbloom when you go, obviously, into the... well, when that spaceship appeared before. Can't remember what those are called. Spaceships, I would presume, coming from space and being a ship. I'm just rocking people's world here. Oh, no. They would have been notified. And there we go, there's a freezing. So it does seem to happen when there's quite a lot of action going on at the screen. That's when that big freeze comes along. In terms of system resources, I am spreading a lot of the load across my system. So in terms of CPU, it is very well optimized. I think because it's so early days with the DirectX 3D 12 rendering going on, it's the GPU that's not been optimized well. And, well, it's a shame, but considering this is the first build I've used using this version, I think that's all right. So I think we have pretty much taken a look at Halo 3. It is good to go, to be honest. You can play it, you can get in game, you can have a bit of a blast around, but by no means is it an enjoyable experience where you would actually play to play the game. As you can see, it just glitches out far too much when the, excuse the language, but when the shit hits the fan, so does the game. And it's a shame, but again, very early days. Hopefully now that this DirectX 3D 12 has been brought in, progress will be pushed forward. I believe, again, it was Ben Vanek that brought this in, and hopefully he can, well, improve upon it along with the other guys. Whoa, I'm seeing some huge breakages going on. What the hell is that? Look at the bloom on that thing. So it looks like this has now started to break up and I need to get out of here before my computer blows up. So what I'll do is I'll put links in the description down below to Ben Vanek and his build. I'll also put a link I found, I think, is his YouTube channel. If it's not, please tell me in the comments and I'll delete that link. But I think it's his YouTube channel. It's not uploaded for a while, but I think it's nice to spread the love. Give him a sub, give him some likes and all that kind of stuff. I think it's awesome, the kind of thing that he's done here, bringing this kind of build to our attention. But other than that, again, I'll put links to everything that's involved with this and anything that may help you. Put in the description down below what you think may help all this, or at least what games you want me to play in the future. And, well, happy days all around. So anyway, thank you very much for joining me. Please like, please subscribe, please do all the magical thing in this magical world where that guy looks like his Predator 2 against my Predator 1 Arbiter. But most of all, you guys have a good day. Laters!